What's good, everybody? It's Jeron, Geronimo Davis here with Erupt Management and Music Group. It's Father's Day, so I just wanted to give a couple quick thoughts on what, you know, being in the music industry means to me, being a father. Just maybe, you know, just ask some questions and maybe give a few music artists and other people in the business some things to think about on this Father's Day. Might be telling my age a little bit, but I got a son that's 18 years old. He is a music producer, and that was not by accident. You know, it wasn't something I planned either. I used to own a recording studio for a number of years in Florida, in Atlanta, and I used to have to just pick my son up, take him to the studio while I had artists recording. You know, so to kind of give him something to do, I would put him on a keyboard, put some headphones on him, let him play with some sounds on an MPC. Luckily, I had a lot of other cool engineers and producers that worked in my studio and artists that would come in that, you know, respected my wishes of making sure that when my son was around, they behaved in a cool manner. You know, but of course, I did understand that this is rap. This is the music industry. There's a lot of content. There's a lot of things that go on that necessarily, you know, young kids, especially a young boy, may not need to be exposed to or understood or even see right now. So I used to have these talks with my son when we would leave the studio about, like, you know, the language he would hear, you know, and different things like that, and tell him that he has to make his own decision on how he wants to use his words, how he treats women, whether he believes what he hears in songs, and takes those types of things to heart. So, you know, a lot of these things that I was doing, I was, you know, of course I had the intentions of doing the right thing. I wanted my son to be interested in music, but there were still a lot of things that I wish I did to make him even better prepared for what he's trying to do now. So for any music artist, whether you play an instrument, whether you sing, whether you rap, my advice would be do it more with your children. Give them the opportunity, buy them the instruments, get them lessons, let them see you create. Don't try to show yourself being a star to them, because none of that really matters right now. You know, they may take the music as an adult, they may not. I didn't expect, you know, for my son to necessarily really dive into it, but that's something that, you know, he's found interesting. So on another note, specifically to rappers that have young sons and daughters, you know the content of what you speak on. This is entertainment, so I'm not knocking you for saying things that you feel are gonna sell and make you more popular amongst, you know, commercial society. But I will say it's your duty to make sure that the things that you say, whether, you know, it's about drugs or your neighborhood or about another person, violence, sexual things about women, things like that, that's going to be up to you to make sure that your kid doesn't really think, you know, that that's actually how you believe and how you act constantly on a day-to-day basis. So it's up to you to have those conversations and make them aware that, you know, this is entertainment. So they have a good understanding, and when they see other music artists and when they're out in the street and they're with their friends and their friends are playing music, they have a different understanding than their friends do. So, you know, that's just my thoughts. I'm not going to, you know, dive too much more into it, but just, you know, just really take the time to, you know, have fun with music with your kids. It's a lifelong gift. I'm not a musician. I'm not a producer. I don't sing. I don't rap. I'm a business guy. But I love music. I always have. And that's why it's a passion of mine. And that's why I'm happy that, you know, my son has taken this on. And it's still my duty to make sure I help him navigate through this business without having to deal with all the pitfalls, to know what's real and what's fake. So peace and love to everybody out there. Happy Father's Day to all the dads out there. Whether you live with your kids, whether you don't, you know, just take the time, do the things that you need to do. If you do that, you know, they'll always be there for you, because you definitely will need them in the future. Peace.